This is Maat. She represent the zero in the middle with the feather, and in each scale is the sun and moon. This is her with her wings spread it. This is Jesus in between the two thieves, the sun and moon in between the North Pole. It will show you the same cosmology. Even the numbers tell this story in a numerical way. And I'm a mute right there.
Hey, can I say something? I want y'all to check this out. No, I just saw that line up with zero through, and it's like making a tent. So I just made a tent from zero like this, and I want y'all to see this. The number nine and its relevance, kind of like this. Okay, and y'all know with decimals, when we do the decimal thing, like everything is like in the tent, like the after the decimal, like 4.5 right here. After this is called the tenths right here. So this is like a decimal is like a 10 basically, like y'all was just saying, like that middle point that y'all was talking about. 6, 7, 8. And then stop at 9. But it's even like 4.5, you got 9. This equals 9. That equals 9. That equals 9. That equals 9. And you know, you got 9. You get what I'm saying? So it just makes like, with the 4.5, and this right here is 9. And then you was talking about the circle.
Hey, yo, brother, let me ask you something. Did your mind just conceive this?
Yes, sir. I just created this.
Brother, can I just tell you, you're a damn genius?
That's a wow.
You are a genius, brother. And you just made.
You did a wow for me too.
Oh man, you just made the step pyramid as well. And the way it add out to 9 when you coordinate them each side like that, it just show you how to math coordinates the sacred geometry, and that's something I haven't even done, brother. You're a damn genius.
What's going on, everybody? I just want to take out the time right now to record how awesome my work looks. As far as now, part of the reason why I've been taking a while too is so that I know the quality. The only way that you can know the quality to something is gonna last as far as when I sell it to these art dealers, and I will be showing this to them. I'm sorry for the trash in the background. But as far as me showing this to art dealers, when you show this and present this to them, you want to make for sure that it's of what you're saying and good quality. One way that I could show and prove that it's great quality is that I've been drawing this for a certain amount of time. I come in 3-4 years later, and then you look at it and it looks like this, basically, is my point of recording this video. So it's been 3 years since I started drawing this. And when you look at what it is that I've drawn, the oldest section is over here. So basically you would look at the oldest section, and this is what it should be fading. And it's showing and proving that, you know, my work isn't fading or anything. Like, even the spots that you look at, you have to be careful. It's not really fading. It's like shining. Shining marks or glares, I mean to say. So it's not faded even there. So the lead itself that I use.
Here I've actually got a little cube magnet. You notice that this was 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 45, 45. This is the centrifugal magnetic. This vector and this vector, and these two are the conjugate geometries of the universe, the hyperboloid, the hourglass shape, and the toroid, or the donut shape. Opposite to those at 45 degrees and 90 degrees to the dielectric, but this is the only place where life exists. Everything out here, of course, is space. These four S vectors are, of course, the four vectors of the toroid. The torus, if I were actually draw this out without making the chalkboard too busy, these would be the four vectors of space. To say magnetism and to say creates space, and also to say creates time, is one and the same thing. Here we have the actual vectors of counterspace, centripetal convergence, the actual geometry.